My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we gather to celebrate the feast of St. Lawrence, one of the most venerated martyrs of the early church. His life and death offer us profound lessons on the virtues of generosity, faith, and the joy that comes from serving others. Our first reading today is from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, 2 Corinthians 9 verses 6 to 10. St. Paul reminds us that God loves a cheerful giver. He encourages us to sow bountifully so that we may also reap bountifully. This passage speaks directly to the heart of St. Lawrence's life and martyrdom. Lawrence, a deacon in the early church, was responsible for the care of the poor and the distribution of alms. When the Roman authorities demanded that he hand over the treasures of the church, Lawrence presented them with the poor, the crippled, the blind, and the suffering, declaring, "These are the treasures of the church." In the Gospel reading from John 12 verses 24 to 26, Jesus tells us, "Unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit." St. Lawrence's ultimate sacrifice was a testament to this truth. He gave his life willingly, knowing that his death would bear much fruit for the kingdom of God. His martyrdom was not an end but a beginning, inspiring countless others to live lives of faith and generosity. St. Lawrence's story challenges us to examine our own lives. Are we generous with our time, talents, and resources? Do we see the face of Christ in the poor and the marginalized? True generosity is not just about giving from our surplus, but giving from our very selves, just as St. Lawrence did. Moreover, St. Lawrence teaches us about the joy that comes from giving. Despite the suffering he endured, he remained joyful, even to the point of making light of his own martyrdom. This joy is a fruit of the Holy Spirit, a sign that our giving is rooted in love and faith. As we reflect on the life of St. Lawrence, let us ask for his intercession to help us grow in the virtue of generosity. May we be inspired to give cheerfully and selflessly, knowing that in doing so, we are storing up treasures in heaven. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the example of St. Lawrence, who showed us the true meaning of generosity and joyful service. Help us to follow his example, to see the treasures of your kingdom in the faces of those in need, and to give of ourselves without counting the cost. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. May God bless you all abundantly. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more uplifting homilies and spiritual reflections.